Welcome to this edition of Making Change Should Make Sense. In this particular video, we'll answer the following question. Why do some people pay $5.05 when their bill is only $1.03? In order to make sense of that, let's first talk about change in general. Assume that a customer's total bill is $3, and let's further assume that the customer has three $1 bills in their pocket, so the customer pays with those $3. In this case, it's easy to see that the bill is equal to what they paid, so we owe that customer no change at all. Now, of course, it's more typical that a customer won't have exact change. So let's say that the total bill is $3, but the customer has a $5 bill in their pocket. In this particular situation, it's clear that we're going to owe them something because the bill is only $3, but they paid $5. In this situation, we would owe them $2. Now, one method that is really nice for making sure that you have calculated the change correctly, and it also helps the customer ensure that they're getting back the right amount to change, is to count it back using this method. So you'd say, all right, the bill is $3, I owe you $2, so that would be 3, 4, 5. And if we do it right, that amount is always going to equal what they paid. And that's because when we look at the math, the bill plus the change is always equal to the amount that they paid. Let's look at another situation. Let's say that the total bill is $6 and the customer pays $10 because they have a $10 bill in their pocket. In this situation, we clearly owe them some change, and it looks like we would owe them $4 in this situation. So again, using the count back method, we would say, all right, your bill was $6, I owe you $4. So 6 and 1 is 7, 8, 9, 10. So again, what we give them back is equivalent to what they paid because the change plus the bill will equal how much they paid. All right, now let's look at this scenario. This gets closer to answering the question that we posed at the beginning of the video. Let's assume that the total bill is $6 and the customer actually pays $11. So the customer pulls out a 10 and a 1 and pays using both those bills. Now it seems like the customer could have just given us the 10 because of course the 10 would cover the $6 bill. Why did the customer decide to give us this $1 bill as well? Well, let's calculate the change and then we can make sense of it. If the customer paid $11, but the bill was only $6, we're gonna owe them $5 in change. And the customer is smart enough to predict that if they are owed $5 in change, the merchant will probably give them a $5 bill. And that's exactly what they're trying to do. They're trying to eliminate the amount of money that they need to carry in their pocket, in their purse, in their wallet, whatever it might be. So instead of having that $1 bill still remaining in their pocket and then getting four $1 bills back, they'd rather just have a $5 bill in return. So in this particular situation, using the count back method, we would say, okay, your bill was $6 plus 5 would be 11, and 11 is what they paid originally. Now, what we're really doing, as I mentioned here, is just exchanging our smaller bills for larger ones, and I think you'll be able to see that more easily on the next slide. So let's go through those two situations we just talked about. Let's assume in one situation, the bill is $6 and the customer is only paying with this $10 bill that the customer has in his or her wallet. So in this situation, the $10 bill is gone because that's what they used to pay. And the customer still has the $1 bill left in their pocket. So we give them $4 back. Now the customer has five $1 bills. In this next situation where the total bill is $6, just like previously, let's assume that the customer pays with the 10 and with the 1. So the customer is paying with $11. We're going to owe that customer now $5 back. So now it's easy to see. What would you rather have in your wallet? Five $1 bills or just this one $5 bill? Now, in most situations, most of the time, people would rather have a higher bill because it simply takes up less room. It's easier to carry. So what we're seeing is that customers are strategically paying so that they will limit the number of bills that they have in their wallet. Now, of course, this works with change as well, and now we'll answer the question that we posed at the beginning of the video. Let's say a customer's bill is $1.03, and let's say that the customer has $5.05 in his or her wallet. And we'll go through two situations. In this first situation, let's just assume that the customer pays with the $5 bill. So if the customer pays $5 for a bill that is $1.03, we owe that customer $3.97 change. So the $5 bill is gone. They gave it to us. Now we're going to give them back $3.97. Remember, they still have the nickel sitting in their pocket. So here's the $3.97. There's 3, 325, 350, 375, 385, 395, 396, 397. So this is what they're left with in their pocket. Now let's look at the next situation. Again, the bill is $1.03. The customer has $5.05 in their pocket. And let's assume in this situation, they're gonna pay $5.05. They're gonna give us everything that was in their pocket. If the bill is only $1.03, we're gonna owe them $4.02 for change. So let's look at what the change would look like. They're gonna give us the $5.05, so that's gone. And now we need to count back $4.02. So there's $4, one, and 2 cents. So again, now it's easy to see by strategically paying with different denominations, different coins, we can limit the amount of change that we have to carry around. So would you rather carry around all this change, or would you rather carry around this right here? And keep in mind, they're equivalent amounts. Here we have $3, $3.25, $3.50, $3.75, $3.80, $3.90, $4, $4 and 2 cents. What do we have right here? $4 and 2 cents. It's just that it would be easier to carry this around than it would be to carry this around. All right, so the next time you need to make change, I hope you're less confused, and actually, I hope you're pretty confident in that now you understand how you can do it. Thanks.